So, Jim, here we are. End of the tour and the beating heart of the school, the staff room.
Thank you. I can't wait to get started and meet the rest of the staff and students.
You see, Jimmy.
Jim, please.
My motto in life is live every day as if it's your last. Doesn't mean you can go around wanking off in school. No, really, don't do that. We had to fire the last guy who did it.
Not sure. What does it look like?
It's big, black. I need it. It's my lucky pen. I've got a class in 10 minutes.
Can't say that I've seen it. What's your name? I'll let you know if I find it.
Okay, it's Amber.
Jim. Pleasure to meet you.
So, I haven't seen you before.
Oh, yeah, it's my first day. Taking over for Mr. McKilkenny.
Oh, good. Horrible business, that. He was a real jerk. I'm sure you'll do a great job, though.
Bad, was it? What happened, exactly?
Oh, I've got to go. Let me know if you find my pen.
No mobiles out in school hours.
God!
It's only me.
Can I help you with something?
Well, I thought we'd just check in. I see you've met some of the other staff.
Oh, well, I haven't really.
What do you think?
About what, sorry?
About Amber, of course.
Ah, John, what are you doing here?
Oh, hello. Nice to meet you. I'm Stephen, head of science.
Yes, anyway, what are you two talking about?
I was just checking with Jim. See how he's doing.
How long have you been here? I mean, at the school, not here.
Oh, I started today, actually.
I was just letting Jim get a feel for the place.
He seems to be getting a pretty good feel right now.
Suppose we'd better let you get on with your business.
Well, nice to meet you.
More of you. Oh, Jesus! You scared me half to death. I thought you were John for a minute.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. What's going on?
No, wait. James, come back. Have a seat. Let me introduce you to Claudia. Sometimes in life, you have a special moment when you find your life's perfect component. It could be the look in the eye, a smile you just can't pass by. You'll travel the world to find the perfect girl. To keep your brain from tripping, you're going to spend all your money on shipping. Claudia, I really adore you. I wish there was more of you. I'm totally in awe of you, my Claudia. Now, Jim, here's the thing. You can't comprehend what she can bring. She make crystal, she make wine, she all you need for a good time. Trust me, thrust me, she's one of a kind. She take my breath away. Now I know what you're gonna say. How can I afford all this on my pay? Well, I'll tell you a secret, if I think you can keep it. If you got glaucoma, I can treat it. So try and be smart, cause you know in your heart the Claudia's art. So why would you want to tear it apart?
That didn't really explain anything.
This way. There you go. Through there.
Wait. So it's Jim.
Okay, Claudia, let's try that from the top, shall we?
Oh. Mind if I join you for lunch?
Of course not. Have a seat. So, have you found my pen yet?
No, not yet. Sorry.
It's okay. I guess I'll just have to borrow one off Marcy.
Oh, you can borrow one off me. I've got one right here.
Oh, no, it's okay. Marcy has the one I really love.
Okay. So, how long have you been at this madhouse for, then?
About a year and a half now.
Oh, hello, you two. So you've been getting to know each other. You've met Jim, our latest addition to the faculty. Hope you've been bonding. Not too much bonding. We don't want another pregnancy. Can't afford to lose another member of staff.
Good one, John. You're a funny guy.
What the bloody hell's that? Brown bread! Brown bloody bread! What sort of a man are you?
Oh, I'm just trying to be a bit more healthy.
I'm trying to be a bit more healthy.
I think it's good. It's good to be healthy. When was the last time you ate a carrot?
It's my least favourite cake, so never. It's for your own good. Buy yourself something nice.
Wasn't my tea? What the hell?
You'll get used to it. Some say he was born and bred that way. But really, he's the yeast of your problem.
I guess he's just trying to get a rise out of me.
I don't get it.
You know, bread rises. It rises when it's baked. It was stupid. Don't worry about it.
Brownies, anyone?
Brownies, excellent. So yes, this is the lunch of champions. None of that brown bread shit. You'll be telling me you've got vitamin water next.
Good one, John.
See, I miss the brownies. Don't tell me. Tibetan mountain goat.
Spirit animals. Pelican. I think it's a compliment.
Mongoose, how are you today? Oh, your chakras feel very aligned.
Oh, thank you, Marcy. I didn't think you were picking up until Friday.
Oh, no, don't worry about that. I was just wondering if you had any brownies left.
Sorry, last batch.
Oh, no worries.
Well, look, I tell you what, the students in my next class, they're not too bright. We could probably make up another batch then.
Oh, fabulous.
Ready? Steady,
cook! Hello and welcome to the show. And can we have a warm round of applause for our very special guest this week, Marcy?
Thank you.
So tell us, Marcy, what have you got in the bag?
Oh, well, today I've bought some oil.
Ah, yep.
Some brownie mix.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and some special medicinal herbs.
Well, they look like very interesting ingredients indeed. And what are you going to make for us today?
Well, today I thought we'd make brownies.
Excellent idea. Can someone start the clock, please? There we are. Now, if you take the oil and mix it in with the tetrahydrocannabinol, and I'll start with the brownie mix.
I think he gets what he's saying most of the time. He normally just rips stuff off from TV. Oh God, you should have seen him when he went through his Breaking Bad phase. John, you wanted to see me?
I have something to tell you. I've got cancer.
Oh my God, John. When did the doctors tell you?
Well, they haven't, but I feel it. I feel it in my bones.
Oh, so you haven't actually been diagnosed yet?
I think it's time. There's no way I can make my medical bills. We're gonna have to build a drug lab in the school. There's no other way.
Oh, I get it. I think that's a great idea. I'll just go and sort it out.
You do that.
A drug lab in a school? How far-fetched.
So, tell me, Marcy, what is it you do?
Oh, well, I teach English, but my true passion lies in the book I'm writing.
Oh, sounds interesting. What's it about?
It's called The Incarnation of Marcy Patterson, and it's a personal journey about the discovery of the female form, gender embodiment, and humanity as its most animalistic, primeval manifestation.
So sex then?
Well, yes, sex. And love, mongoose. Yes. Love. Love is a very important part, well, of one of the chapters.
Well, I, for one, am very much looking forward to reading it. So when can we expect to see it in the shelves?
Oh, soon, very soon. I'm just waiting for the right time to release it. You know, spiritually.
Great. Well, I seem to be finished. How are you doing?
I'm done.
Okay, now what we do is we take the oil and we pour it in with the brownie mix. And we stir very quickly.
Oh, how long will these take to bake?
Well, now that we've done this bit, we're going to pop it in the oven at gas mark 4 to 3 to 5 minutes, depending on crispiness and various other factors. But fortunately, we don't need to do that because here's a batch that I made earlier.
Oh, mongoose. You had a batch all along.
You see, now I've taught you how to fish.
Fish? But I'm vegan.
Well, I've given you the knowledge, you see, and that's very important in the world of science.
I'm fairly certain this comes under cookery, not science.
I think you find it science.
What? Well, that's really out of my tea.
Anyway, thank you for coming on the show. Can we have a round of applause, please, for Marcy?
Thank you. My pleasure.
No, I think he actually spoke to Steve, the chemistry teacher, about it. Fortunately, that wore off.
I'd hate to see what would happen if they watched Game of Thrones.
Shh! We don't talk about that here.
Sorry. So, what do you watch on TV then?
Nothing really. Although I did watch a show last night, a dating programme, but it was about their shoes or something. They make anything into TV these days.
That sounds terrible. It couldn't be worse than a show I watched last night. It was called something like It Just Ain't Sport. Yeah, it was terrible.
I'll remember to miss it.
So, what you're saying is that you kissed John.
Fine. It did happen, but there was mistletoe and it was a special time.
Yeah, whatever you say. I think John definitely thought it was a special time.
Well, I guess any kiss from me is special.
If it turns me into John, I'm not sure I'd want one.
Well, fine. I see how it is.
Oh, no. I was joking. I'm sure John was like that before.
Yeah, he was. You can't blame me for that.
Has he always been, you know, John?
Well, I think when he first started here, he was more normal. It all started when we got him a Netflix account. It used to be the odd reference here and there, but now he can't stop.
Sounds pretty serious. Is there a cure?
We have tried, but we're slowly losing hope. Besides, it's quite fun to watch him make the other staff members squirm.
Ah, well, should have seen me. Nerves of steel.
That's not what I've heard. Steve said you were squirming like a little baby.
Well, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I was like a mix between a teacher and James Bond.
I don't believe that for a second. The year nines I teach have more cool than you.
Well, I guess I'll have to ask them for a few tips then, won't I?
Well, if you like, you could help me carry a few supplies to my next class. I'll be sure to help you network.
Yeah, that sounds nice.
Just in there.
I really hope this is for sex ed.
Time after time, and still he doesn't realise. Come on! Oh! Come on! Woo! Let's get it on!
did the sandwich do to deserve that?
Guys, you two haven't seen Dad? Brownies?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
John, can I have a word? I wanted to talk to you about going somewhere different on the school trip this year. Somewhere we can really expand the children's minds.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Well, instead of going to an archaic museum built on the destructions of cultures throughout civilization, I thought we could go to a museum of life. It's this wonderful farm where people have been living together in a community for tens of years. Living together, loving together, becoming one.
Is this because you're banned from the museum?
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
Free the nipple! Free the nipple! Free the nipple! Free the nipple! Free the nipple!
Oh, come on. It really is a chance for the children to grow their hearts as well as their minds.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Just, have you got any food?
Oh, you mean we can go? Oh, I promise we won't leave any children there, and the suicide pact is just for the hardcore members.
Sorry, what?
Oh, Gerbil. He's cute when he's high.
Yeah, he's cute when he's not talking or moving.
Jack! Jack, over here, son.
It's Jim.
Jim! Jimmy! Jimbo! Yeah, so you know my little secret. You're not going to tell anybody, right?
Oh, yeah, that's fine. I won't say a thing.
You better not.
No, I promise, I won't.
Yeah. Yeah, we're good. We're good. Yeah, we're cool. We're all cool. On the same page, yeah? Good. You've got something in your eye.
Oh. Look into my eyes, not around the eyes, but into the eyes. You'll remember nothing about your trip to the little boy's room. And
back in the room. You feeling all right? Look a little pale. Have a seat. I'll get you a glass of water.
Divine angels and ascended masters.
Nope, just Bernard.
Yes, I know. You're a bit close right now.
Well, it's not exactly the first time, is it?
I know.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree.
Not now, Bennett.
Yes, now. I don't think you understand just how intertwined our souls really are. I just can't ignore that.
Can you at least try?
Today is gonna be the day.
Well, this is mighty exciting.
Yeah, now you know why I stay. It might be crazy around here, but it is kind of family.
Yeah, I've heard that.
It really is special around here, though. Back in the day, John used to be an insomniac office worker, looking for a way to change his life. Then he changed paths with this guy, formed this. Formed us an underground club with the potential to change an entire generation of slaves with white collars.
Isn't that Fight Club?
Oh, I don't know them.
Oh, it's a film with Brad Pitt, Edward Norton.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
Well, maybe we could watch it sometime.
Yeah, that would be nice.
How about tonight? I was thinking maybe we could grab a drink after.
Yeah, I'd like that. Oh, I've got some of Steve's special wine. It's really good. I've no idea where he gets it.
I'm not sure you want to know.
Come on, Rhino!